guys, thanks for tuning in again. My name is Kanad, and today we're going to talk about this beautiful instrument right here, the Stanford Crossroads Marquee. I'm going to start off by saying that this is one of the best, if not the best guitar that I've ever played. And yes, Stanford sent me this guitar to review, but they're not paying me to say anything. And in fact, this is just a loaner, so everything you hear is just my opinion and it's not influenced by anything else. Massive thanks to the guys at Stanford and iMusic Distributions for letting me loan this guitar so I can share it with you. I really appreciate it. I also wanted to say sorry because I haven't been uploading lately, and that's because I had to go back home for a couple of weeks and I didn't have my gear with me, so normally I couldn't record anything. But I'm back and I promise you I have a lot of great content to share with you guys. So if you want to support my channel, the best thing you can do is leave the video a thumbs up and just hit that subscribe button. All right, let's get into it. Now this guitar retails at around 899 euros, and with that price it comes with a hard shell case. The case is just solid, the latches on it just work perfectly, and is ready to go. The guitar is made in China, but don't let that scare you off because the build quality is just amazing. In fact, it's made in the same factory where BNG makes their stepsister models, and they retail at around 1500 to 1600 euros. Now, as per usual, we're going to start with the headstock and end up with the pickups and the electronics. Now, the headstock design is just classic, and it's called the Larson headstock, and I'm pretty sure you're going to enjoy looking down at it while playing. The tuners here are Clouson Supreme tuners, and they have these tulip style tuning keys, which look great in my opinion. They work perfectly fine, they're smooth, they keep the guitar in tune, no complaints there. The nut is actually a bone nut, and it's cut very well, and it makes tuning stability a dream. The neck itself is made out of mahogany, and it has this thick profile neck with a 12-inch radius that I really enjoy. It's not a baseball bat by any means, but it's just a nice profile that really feels comfortable for me, at least. Now this guitar has this interesting neck joint, and I didn't notice it at the beginning, but it kind of does help you with upper fret axis a little bit when you get into the last frets here. Now the fretboard is made out of a wood called Catalox, which it's also known as Royal Mexican Ebony, and according to my research it also said that this is one of the strongest woods out there. And that might help with the neck stability and all that, but it might not. I mean, I don't study woods. I just know that it looks good. It's nice and dark and it feels smooth under the fingers. Now the fret job on this guitar is just exceptional. I mean, there's no sharp fret ends whatsoever. You can't even see the tooling marks when you zoom in on the pictures. And the frets are smooth and it just looks like someone took the time to fret this guitar, and it just plays wonderfully. And the frets themselves are medium jumbo, but to me, they feel like they're just a little bit bigger than medium jumbo. Now the body and the neck are mahogany, and it appears that the body is a three-piece mahogany body, and whereas the top is a book matched, I know it's a solid maple top, but it seems like it's a very gorgeous book matched maple top, and I really, really, really enjoy the looks of it. I mean, look at that. What's not to love about that? It also has this 3D thing to it. It's just beautiful, gorgeous. You can also see that there's binding around the guitar, but there's no binding on the neck or on the headstock. And I mean, I like the look of no binding on the neck, and it just reminds me of those old Gibson ES-335s that were made in 58, I think, where they didn't have any binding at all on the necks. So there's two things that makes this guitar totally different and unique to others. First thing is that the wings of this guitar, the sides, are totally hollow, and there's a center block running through the metal made out of mahogany where you can install the bridge and the pickups. Now, this does a couple of things. It makes the guitar resonate a lot more. It gives this airy quality to it, to the sound of it, and it just makes the guitar light. I mean, this is 2.7 kilograms, which is a dream to kick with. I mean, that's going to be a major selling factor for these. They're very light and they're very good sounding. Now let's get to the bridge. So the bridge is your classic Tune-O-Matic stop bar tailpiece design, and it functions very well. The only thing I can say is that the actual Tune-O-Matic is quite narrow, but there's still space for you to adjust your intonation. In fact, the D string was the only string that wasn't intonated correctly, so I just moved the saddle forward a little bit and a problem was solved, easy as that. Now the pickups on this are based on PAF style pickups, and man, do they sound good. I mean, they're very articulate, they're very dynamic, and they have this really smooth brightness and smooth mid-range to them, which just makes the guitar really enjoyable to play, and it makes it a hell lot more versatile than most other guitars. In all honesty, the bridge pickup sounds like a really, really good P90 pickup, and I think that's what Gibson was going with the PAFs in the 50s. So without further ado, let's hear this guitar in all three positions, and then I'll get back with my final thoughts and summary. So there you have it, folks. Now the question is it worth getting this guitar? Well, for me at least, it's very rare for me to find a piece of gear that inspires me to play, inspires me to write music, to record music, inspires me to gig. And this guitar is doing exactly that for me. I mean, as soon as I got this guitar, I just started playing it, and I haven't stopped for a long time, and it's quite concerning. In fact, I'm having a really hard time making this video, talking here, because I play all the time, and it's just, I'm like 33 minutes in, and I've done like 10, like 5 minutes of talking or something like that, but I've been playing it all the time, so that's a really good sign in my book. I mean, all the thoughts that I have when I pick up this guitar is I just want to grab it and go gig somewhere. Now you can find the link to purchase this guitar under the description, and if you have any questions, just leave them under the comment section down below, and I'll try to answer to them as soon as possible. And if I don't have any answers, I'll just forward them to the people at Stanford. In my opinion, the price is very reasonable because it's just a great guitar. And it also comes with a hardshell case, which is a very big plus in my book. Oh, and another thing is that it's a very versatile guitar. I mean, you can play anything you want with it. In fact, I forgot to add it on the playing, but it does that woman tone very, very well. Take a load of this. Let me know what you think about this guitar under the comment section down below. Again, massive thanks to Stanford and iMusic Distributions for sending this over. I mean, I appreciate it a lot. Thank you very much for the opportunity. So that will be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you like what you see, please do consider to subscribe, because that really, really helps a lot. Thank you so much for your time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.